Now, I wanted to get Alex Newman on because he's an international journalist, educator, author, and consultant. He writes for the New American Magazine and WorldNet Daily. And the website is thenewamerican.com. I've gone over the different permutations of the UN treaty. I remember their small arms treaty they tried to get ratified by the U.S. in 2001. The July 7th copy said, quote, civilian ownership of firearms threatens the legitimate power monopoly of the state. Now, that's a very true statement, except for one word, legitimate. Civilian ownership of firearms threatens the power monopoly of the state. That's a true statement, not civilian ownership of firearms threatens the legitimate power monopoly of the state. Mao Zedong said that political power grows out of the barrel of a gun. And the Chinese historians believe he killed 84 million people. The CIA says it's 66 million. The CIA, and I'd always heard this from the folks at the John Birch Society, the New American, and whistleblowers, and they're making some congressional testimony. But it was declassified 15 years ago, and it's even been on History Channel, that the CIA did send rifles with no firing pins or bolts to Chiang Kai-shek and the Nationalist, that they did secretly arm Mao Zedong, and there was even a faction of U.S. government people there from Army Intelligence and others that they helped people like John Birch, who they killed, tortured and killed, that's why it's called John Birch Society, roll up and put the communist in charge. And David Rockefeller wrote his famous op-ed when, I think it was 76 or 77, when Mao died, praising what he did. He killed about triple what Hitler did and about double what Stalin did. Greatest mass murderers in history. Mao Zedong, Joe Stalin, V.I. Lenin, Adolf Hitler has fourth place, ladies and gentlemen. Fourth place. Fourth place. And they praise him. And the guys just found the op-ed piece from the New York Times. Was my history right that it was 76? I forget what year. It was 77. We can put that back on screen, that New York Times. From a China traveler, David Rockefeller. And if you blow it up, it'll say the date. But the point is, David Rockefeller went in before Nixon made his deal with China publicly and set all this up to leverage planetary government between China and the U.S. to bring in this new system. And now with the Trans-Pacific Partnership and with all these treaties and Obama saying he'll sign and implement treaties outside of Congress ratifying them. Open borders, that's part of the U.N. Treaty UNESCO. The Trans-Texas Corridor is part of the North American Union Integration by Stealth Plan. All of this is happening. And we see Obama trying to ban the importation of guns and ammo, citing UN policy and previous treaties. So joining us to discuss the attack on the Second Amendment is Alex Newman. Then at the bottom of the hour, specifically, a discussion of the UN. Now I want to explain some. People always say, get us out of the UN, get rid of the UN. It's the problem. It is the problem. But robber barons in our country, in Europe, and in China, and in the UK created it. The Rockefellers gave the land in New York. They financed it. And more than 100 other globalist organizations to bring in this planetary corporate government where the ultra-rich are above the law. And I've read this quote twice today from Gary Allen, journalist Gary Allen, who wrote None Dare Call a Conspiracy. If one understands that socialism is not a share the wealth program, but is in reality a method to consolidate and control the wealth, then the seeming paradox of super rich men promoting socialism becomes no paradox at all. And his son has joined the dark side and runs and founded Politico. Just like Ron Paul knew, and I guess could call him friends, Alan Greenspan in the 70s, when he wrote books and libertarian books, published like three of them that I've read personally, and essays about the Federal Reserve, the New World Order, world government, planetary regime, how gold standard or silver standard was the answer, and they went and hired Alan Greenspan. See, a lot of folks end up deciding to kneel to Emperor Palpatine. To use that allegory, rise. You will now be known as Darth Vader. Let's go ahead and go to Alex Newman joining us. Alex, I tell you, they are really bold. They're moving fast right now. Let's break down exactly what's in this treaty, because there's a new congressional report out today where the feds are in emails admitting they're shutting down gun shops by ordering banks not to let them have bank accounts. And they're shutting down major gun websites to even have accessories outside of law. Isn't that like the Nazis throwing stuff through Jewish shopkeepers' windows and outside of law not letting them have businesses?
You know, you're absolutely right that the attack on gun rights is coming now fast and furious. It's been accelerating recently, and the United Nations now is at the point where they're just brazenly and openly saying that, you know, our gun rights, our Second Amendment is a human rights violation. We need to get rid of self-defense. We need to get rid of stand your ground. And most recently, after Ferguson and after the police shot that 12-year-old boy, they again attacked gun rights. So that's four or five times in the last year or so. And they're just getting so brazen about it now that they're, you know, putting out press releases attacking our gun rights. And the Obama administration, of course, is fully on board with this. So the attack on gun rights is becoming very brazen. You know, now the UN is pushing for expanded background checks under the guise of human rights. And, you know, that's so extreme that even the Democrats couldn't get it through the Senate when the Democrats controlled the Senate. So that should give people a hint about how extreme these UN positions are. But, you know, it's par for the course for the UN. Just a few years ago, they were helping the government down in Venezuela disarm the citizens there, the law-abiding citizens, of course. The government gets to keep its monopoly on power. And it's just, in my opinion, it's unbelievable that we're at a point now where the UN feels like it can openly attack our gun rights as a human rights violation and get away with it. And it's only because the Obama administration is so anti-gun, I think, that this is able to proceed so openly like this. But it's becoming brazen. They have the Arms Trade Treaty coming into effect on December 24th. Like you said, Obama is talking about implementing these UN treaties without even getting approval from the Senate, as is required.
And the Senate's had to, as you know, the Senate has had to threaten Obama that he better not try that. But then they never follow through when he does what he wants. The UN has criticized Obama for not opening the borders up enough. Meanwhile, they don't criticize North Korea. They don't criticize Communist China. They don't criticize China selling and trafficking in human organs. They only criticize countries that have free market economics.
Yeah, that's right. And I'm actually doing a big report on this right now for the printed version of the magazine. I mean, this entire human rights bureaucracy at the UN is beyond a sick joke. I mean, you have communist dictators on there. The regime in China sits on the Human Rights Council, the regime in Saudi Arabia that beheads people for converting to Christianity, the Cuban regime that's enslaving the people of Cuba. So these are the human rights people that are now lecturing the United States. But you said something before that I think is right on the money. You know, the UN would not be able to get away with this stuff if the globalists in our country and the globalists in Europe were not fully behind the entire thing. I mean, we could just laugh off the UN as a ridiculous joke if it wasn't for the fact that we have the Obama administration and the globalists behind him and the Council on Foreign Relations empowering. I call it the Dictators Club. A lot of people call it the Dictators Club, and that's an accurate description of what we're talking about here. You know, Zimbabwe, Sudan, mass murdering regimes. Can sit on the Human Rights Council. Gaddafi chaired the Human Rights Commission in 2006. So we have here an outfit that literally should be ridiculed by the entire world. And you're exactly right. Rather than attacking countries that actually do have human rights violations, they put the worst human rights violators on the Human Rights Council and then have them attack the United States for our actual rights, like our gun rights and our self-defense rights and our rights to free speech. They want hate speech laws. So it would be a cruel and ridiculous joke, except for the fact that our globalists here in the United States and in Europe are fully behind this organization.
I'm no fan of the police state. I'm known for being the guy that criticizes it and is trying to stop it, but it doesn't mean I'm against the individual police themselves. We can see classic communist liberation theology with the Democratic Party and others trying to have class warfare now between the general public and the police. I mean, this is so transparent.
Yeah, that's exactly what's going on, Alex. I'm so glad you mentioned that. You know, they're trying to stir up any tensions and any hatred that they can Just keep the public distracted from the real criminals. You know, have the police and the citizens at war with each other, the blacks and the whites at war with each other, the rich and the poor, the men and the women. Any kind of division, arbitrary, ridiculous, whatever, they'll exploit it as long as it keeps the attention off of them and off of their
criminals. That's right, because the globalists are an enemy alien operation, and what would an enemy do? It would divide the people so it could take them over. Alex Newman, let's look at this treaty and the fight that's coming up in the House and in the Senate to stop Obama, who's announced he's going to move unilaterally on this and more. Stay with us.
This holiday season, give the gift that keeps on giving, an in-home freeze dryer from Harvest Right. With your very own freeze dryer, you'll be able to freeze dry the food your family loves. Because we live in uncertain, difficult times, what better way to show your love for your family than to buy them a gift that helps them preserve food they can use now or in 25 years? Go to HarvestRight.com and find out how you can get your in-home freeze dryer. Layaway is available. That's HarvestRight.com.
Managing your business and customers isn't easy, huh? SnapForce Customer Relationship Software may be just what you need. SnapForce CRM is a software solution that helps you manage everything important about your customers, from sales to marketing to service and support. All of your customer information is right there at your fingertips for easy access. It's time to take control of your business in a snap. Get your free trial at SnapForce.com. That's SnapForce.com. SnapForce.com.
What looks good under your Christmas tree and tastes even better? Big Berkey water filters. Yes, the gift of clean water. A gift that provides a great foundation for achieving good health in the lives of your loved ones. A Big Berkey water filter gives them protection from bacteria, heavy metals, chlorine, fluoride, pesticides and herbicides, VOCs and more. And best of all, a Big Berkey water filter is a gift that lasts for many years with no additional investment. And that saves time and money in filter replacements that other water filters require and are even powerful enough to purify treated, untreated, or even stagnant pond water. As always, all orders over $50 are shipped free, and GCN listeners get 5% off all ceramic filter systems. Order online at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com, spelled Big, B-E-R-K-E-Y, WaterFilters.com, or call 877-99-BERKEY. That's 877-99-BERKEY. Gift well this Christmas. Give a Big Berkey water filter.
Hi folks, Alex Jones here with some important information. I want to tell you about Matt Redhawk and his team of patriots over at My Patriot Supply. Several years ago, Matt was sitting in his two-bedroom apartment, frustrated with the direction this country was headed and the charlatans willing to sell us out for a quick buck. Deciding to take action, a company run by patriots for patriots was born. My Patriot Supply has never taken a loan or accepted outside funding. They now operate two distribution facilities and employ over 50 hardworking American men and women. It is rare to find companies who practice what they preach. And that's why I stock my pantry with high-quality storable foods from My Patriot Supply. Go to MyPatriotSupply.com/Alex today for special offers on emergency food storage or call their preparedness specialist at 866-229-0927. That's 866-229-0927. Do business with someone who shares your values. MyPatriotSupply.com/Alex.
What disaster is so powerful? It unleashes a chain of mass pandemics, economic meltdowns, and violent food riots, all at the same time. NASA has already set the countdown timer, and right now the 21st century apocalypse is less than 13 months away. Former CIA Director James Woolsey says 2/3 of U.S. population could perish. In a matter of seconds, the world as we know it will cease to exist. The world's economy will be wiped out. Mass riots will follow. Ancient diseases will reemerge. How will you shield yourself and your loved ones from this upcoming apocalypse? Go to darkestdays.info to find out proven methods of protecting yourself, your loved ones, and even your entire community when this worst-case scenario unravels. That's darkestdays.info. Darkestdays.info. Go there before this life-saving information becomes unavailable to the large public. Go to darkestdays.info now.
I'm going to give the phone number out, and we're going to take calls coming up. Alex Newman of the New American Magazine is our guest. I'm Alex Jones. For the last year, I've been hearing about Infowars.com, Alex Jones billboards in Florida and Arkansas and Texas and New Jersey and Missouri, just all over. And radio stations have bought us billboards, and citizens have done it here and there. It's happened probably hundreds of times. But whoever's doing this has done a whole bunch of them. And I had a caller last week who told us who it was, and then I asked them to give the number, and I don't think it got followed or happened. So I want to discover who you are, if you want to be known, and have you on the show and talk about it, because I think it's an example of what other people could step up and do, especially if there's a local AM or FM in the area, to tell folks to also tune into that station. This is just another great way to get the word out. Because if you come listen to this show, you will find out exactly what's going on. Very exciting. So we salute whoever's doing it. Email us, contact us. Who is the mysterious info warrior posting billboards nationwide? InfoWars billboards mysteriously appear on America's interstates. And I'm told they're all over the place. Commenters are going, yeah, I'm in New York. Yeah, I'm in Illinois. Yeah. And it's the same one. It's a good-looking billboard. And if more citizens stepped up and did that, it could be a huge effect. A huge effect. I'm going to now move back to our guest. But that's what this broadcast is a watchman on the wall, a watchwoman on the wall, telling you what's going on. And even if I'm bombastic, sometimes fine. I got all these great reporters, all these great guests, all these other researchers. It's about the information. I'm just here blowing the trumpet. Sometimes I don't like the way it sounds, but I'm raising the alarm. We need you to raise the alarm. We have the power to change things. One arrogant case like Gruber calling us dumb fools and how they ripped us off could bring them down. And these people can't change their spots. They keep acting arrogant. Alex, I think that's a big part of the reason I'm confident, is history shows tyrants and their minions love to brag. They always go too far. They never stop pushing. They think they're going to hide their world government, but it's so big, it's so out in the open now, they don't laugh at us when we talk about the Federal Reserve being private. They don't laugh at us when we talk about world government. When mainstream media criticizes me, they don't even say he's nuts and thinks there's a plan for world government. They say he criticizes the move to world government. I mean, we've come so far since the days that Mr. Welch founded the group that has your magazine. Talk about where you see the world right now. Then I want to come back and drill into the treaty itself and take phone calls. The toll-free number to join us specifically on the UN and on this treaty is 800-259-9231. We're discussing the stealth but also extrajudicial move to take our guns, 888-253-3139. This is only a few minutes left in this short segment, Alex. What do you think the real state of the world is right now?
You know, I think thanks to patriots like you, and you're doing a really great service to humanity, Alex. A lot of people have woken up because of the work that you're doing. But, you know, with what you're doing and what the whole alternative media is doing, it's shifted the debate, and the globalists know this. I don't know that they're scared yet, but they realize that people are waking up right and left every day. That's why we see the drive to censor the internet and, you know, to pass hate speech laws, to censor the truth and censor criticism of the political class. So I think they're nervous. I think they realize that humanity's waking up. And, you know, as we get closer to this criminal world government that they're trying to set up, it's going to become more and more obvious to more and more people. It's going to step on people's toes. It's going to force people to come out of their comfort zone, you know, tune out the football for a little bit and realize that what's happening here is serious and it's going to affect every one of us. So I think the globalists realize this, and I think the patriots realize this. Now, you know, it's a race against time, but with God on our side, I'm very confident that the globalists can be at least defeated and held back for a significant amount of time. And, you know, they think they're moving into their new world order. They call it the new world order. They think it's coming soon, but I beg to differ.
That's right. A planetary, corporate, anti-free market, anti-human, total surveillance grid, cutting off our resources. I mean, this is total enslavement. Everyone should take it personal and should make it one of the main focuses of their lives to study it, to know we're telling the truth, and then to move against it. But people always want some silver bullet, Alex, that's going to fix it all overnight. There is no silver bullet. It is resisting it, speaking out against it, and withdrawing our consent.
That's right. And you know what you do, Alex, is exactly what people need to be doing. Get information out there. Get the truth out there. Educate your community. Educate the electorate. That's how we're going to get good politicians in office. That's how we're going to restore the Constitution. And that's how we're going to bring justice to criminals who want to take our guns, for example, or build a criminal world government. So we need awareness, we need education, and you're doing a great job.
No, you are, Alex, and the New American, and all the listeners out there. We're all in this together, brother. All right, we'll be right back with your phone calls, and we're going to look at the treaty and other globalist treaties. They're moving on all fronts in a bum rush of desperateness. They're behind schedule.
We're on the march. The empire's on the...
And we also have the nightly news, 7 o'clock. Every weeknight, Monday through Friday, 7 o'clock Central. And when big events happen, sometimes we go live for 6-7 hours. But every night, 7 o'clock Central. One membership. We just have memberships to pay for the bandwidth. And as bandwidth gets cheaper over the years, we lower the price and offer more memberships. One $5.95 a month membership. You create a username and passcode that's unique to the site that you can share with friends and family. And 20 people can simultaneously log in with the same username. 20 people can simultaneously log in with the same username. I mean, most people aren't going to tune in every night. I wish they would. You could probably give this to 50 people and then never be locked out yourself. But if you ever went there and were locked out, praise God, 20 people are on there simultaneously using it. Go buy another membership and repeat it. $5.95 a month. That helps pay for the crew, the cameras, and the bandwidth, and building the news division so we can send reporters around the world, send reporters to hot spots, have the investigative journalists, have the writers, have the researchers, and we're still running until the end of the year, the special, where you can get half off. Half off, $29.95 instead of $59.95 for a year membership. PrisonPlanet.tv. Lastly, I want to thank everyone out there that is a member and encourage you to share it with friends and family. But you can do your Christmas shopping right now. Go get a membership. Takes about a minute to sign up. And then give an e-card or physical card with, hey, here's a cool documentary website that has its own underground news. This is some pretty powerful stuff. Check it out. You probably have heard of Alex Jones, but this is where you can find it all in HD and more, prisonplanet.tv. Or forbidden information, here's your passcode. And then give that card. It's a way to save a lot of money for the holidays, for Christmas. Now, a great way to give yourself good health and a healthy GI is Oxy Powder. Oxygen-based intestinal cleanser, dietary supplement, clinically tested. This has been Dr. Group's flagship product for more than a decade. It's used in Hollywood. Big Hollywood stars have been on record saying how they go down multiple dress sizes with it. And the average person has about 20 pounds of rotten food in their intestines. I'm not going to get graphic here. Everybody knows that. Rob Dew, in 1 week taking it, he was on about a month ago, people responded by his testimony. I was like, man, this Oxy powder, I just did it, lost a few more pounds. And he goes, yeah, man, I lost, I think it's 17 or 18 pounds in 7 days on it. And he was already not fat. He had a stomach sticking out for a reason. That's because it's all full of, you know what? I mean, you know, they say Bill Clinton's full of, well, he needs some Oxy powder to flush out his brain, though. That's where it's backed up to, you know, his brain there. I'm not trying to be gross. The point is trying to be funny. Oxy powder, we have a supply of it, but Group's going to be out of it. We're going to be out of it. I would order it now and give yourself as a New Year's resolution to start using it now right through into next year. There are about 3 cleanses on average in each bottle. What, 100 capsules? In there, 100 milligrams each, and it will elemental magnesium, ozonated magnesium, natural citric acid, and more, and it just flushes you out and releases in the intestines. Oxy powder. It's 120 vegetarian capsules. I'm sorry, I said 100. I always tend to downgrade using my memory for some reason. I'm very inaccurate, almost always downgrading things, as folks have actually tracked and looked into what I say. It's not on purpose. It's just that it's 120 capsules. Suggested you start by taking 4 capsules with an 8-ounce glass of water on an empty stomach before going to bed. If you do not achieve 3 to 5 movements the following day. Increase your serving to 2 capsules each night until 3 to 5 are achieved each day. Continue in this quantity for 6 consecutive days. Rob Dew didn't have that big of an effect at 4. He's a big guy, like 6'3". He went to 7 capsules, and it was spectacular. I'm going to shut up now. For best results, add the juice of 1/2 lemon, preferably organic, to your water when taking the capsules. Drink plenty of water during the day when using Oxy powder. Life-changing, InfoWarsLife.com, along with the other products. We're sold out of the B12, Secret 12. More of it's coming in. We may be able to offer it before Christmas. If your orders are in by December 17th, that gives us another 9 days. You will get it before Christmas, and it supports the transmission. All right, I'm going to shut up now and give Alex Newman of the NewAmericanMagazine.com the floor to talk about the treaty, the Trans-Pacific Partnership, and why he thinks they're moving on so many fronts right now. Then we're going to go to Chad, Jim, Kevin, Nate, Leon, and others that are patiently holding. Again, thenewamerican.com. Alex, you've got the floor.
Basically, there's a number of really important treaties that are moving through the process right now that people need to be aware of. Each of them infringes on our sovereignty and on our inalienable God-given rights. I think the Arms Trade Treaty is one of the most important. Article 2 right there basically defines for us that citizens do not have a right to own guns or ammunition or any type of self-defense weapon that's listed in there. Article 3 deals with ammunition. And initially, at least, the treaty mandates that national governments form a registry with the eventual goal of confiscation, because as the treaty explains, the idea is that only authorized state parties should have access to firearms and weaponry. Now, when people think of authorized state parties, I want them to think of, you know, Mugabe in Zimbabwe, Chairman Mao, you were talking about before, you know, mass murders, the Sudan's Omar Bashir, you know, genocidal guy, killed a bunch of people in Darfur. So these are the authorized state parties that we're talking about. Kim Jong-un in North Korea, Fidel Castro and Raul Castro in Cuba. These are the people that the UN thinks deserve to have guns. And us citizens, we don't get any guns. And the UN has made that clear for a long time. They, like I said before, they recently helped disarm the people of Venezuela, who are, as your listeners probably know, living under a regime that also does not really respect freedom and human rights and God-given rights. So the Arms Trade Treaty, that's a big one. The UN says it's going to go into effect on December 24th. Of course, the Senate has not ratified it, but Obama, as always, is scheming to implement at least parts of it without ratification. Then we have, of course, the Trans-Pacific Partnership, which is an idea to merge the United States further into these regional building blocks of the New World Order. This one involves the communist dictatorship in Vietnam, for example, and presumably it would eventually expand to include others. Then they're trying to merge the United States with the European Union through the Transatlantic Trade and Investment Partnership. You know, people who know anything about the European Union should instantly realize why that's a terrible idea. All of these so-called free trade agreements, one of the things that they do is set up international tribunals that can overrule state law, that can overrule federal law. So basically, we lose our right to govern ourselves. We would be governed by unaccountable international bureaucracies. And, you know, these have nothing to do with trade. I'm not opposed to free trade. I think free trade is a good thing. But we're not talking about free trade here. We're talking about managed trade, thousands of pages of regulations and international bureaucracy.
We're talking about government. I mean, exactly. That's how they set up the EU, was calling it a free trade commonwealth.
That's exactly right. And we have, you know, the North American Free Trade Agreement. The European Union started with the European Free Trade Agreement. So they thought they were going to build the North American Union here. Robert Pastor, the founding father of that idea, he credited the John Birch Society with killing the plan. But as the CFR made clear, even recently this year, they still have plans for, you know, this big North American super bloc that would basically usurp the sovereignty and the liberties of the people of the United States and Mexico and Canada. But one thing I want to mention about all these treaties, it all sounds like gloom and doom. One thing that needs to become more widely known, treaties are not in and of themselves the supreme law of the land. There's this misconception promoted by the government and by the UN that, you know, the US government signs a treaty, the Senate ratifies it, suddenly whatever it says in that treaty is the law of the land. That's just simply not the case. Thomas Jefferson, you know, the author of the Declaration of Independence, one of the most important founding fathers, he made that absolutely clear in his letters and his writings. Treaties do not supersede the Constitution. They do not grant any new powers to the federal government that weren't granted by the Constitution. And the Supreme Court has agreed with this interpretation as recently as 57 in Reed versus Covert. They said the federal government cannot assume any new powers just by signing a treaty. So, I mean, that's really one of the big stumbling blocks here for the globalists. They have to literally distort what the Constitution says to pretend like all these treaties purporting to grant the federal government and the UN all this power are legitimate. They're not legitimate. They're simply not legitimate. It doesn't matter if the Senate ratifies them. The federal government cannot expand its powers with a treaty. The Supreme Court has said so. The Founding Fathers said so. The Constitution says so. And it's very clear. So if we can expose the truth and the facts and the globalists, you know, I see clear skies ahead. We can do a lot of good things, but it's going to require effort from everybody to educate their legislators, educate their congressmen, educate their city council, educate their communities about these facts so that we can avoid the future that these, maniacs is a good way to call them, have planned for us.
Well, you're right. The constitutional scholars are legion on the fact that a treaty does not trump a domestic law. But regardless of that, Obama is saying he will order agencies to follow treaties, even if Congress doesn't ratify. Let me ask you this question. What do you make of Mitch McConnell and John Boehner and others refusing to repeal Obamacare, refusing to go after him, refusing to impeach him, refusing to shut down the government to force him to not have executive amnesty? I mean, this really shows us that the globalists are controlling the leadership of both parties. You got a lot of great grassroots people that just came into office. I don't know how they think they're going to get away with this. And having people like Jonathan Gruber traipsing around, admitting it's a way to socially engineer and raise taxes, and then his own party running from him but still defending the legislation. We have to come to grips with the fact that we really are dealing with a group of criminals.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, no doubt the leadership of the GOP is controlled by neocons and globalists, same Council on Foreign Relations that controls the Obama administration and the UN. And that's obvious just by their fruits. You know, by their fruits, you shall know them. We can look very clearly at Congress. They just got a huge Republican majority, and they're relying on the ignorance of the American people and on Republican voters in particular to not understand that they have the complete and total power to stop any of this. All they have to do is refuse to provide funding for it. All funding has to come from the House of Representatives. If the House does not approve funding for Obama's imperial decrees, for the UN climate, they're not even calling it a treaty now because Obama knows he won't get it ratified, but they can deny funds for any of this.
That's
and
right.
All Obama do is kick and scream. So they're relying on our ignorance to get away with this kind of stuff. But if we can educate the American people, show them that, you know, the House has the power to cut the funding for any of this, the whole charade crumbles. And I hope that, you know, a lot of these new grassroots Republicans that got elected, I hope
that's
they right. will go down.
Well, that's why Congress keeps playing dumb. Like, we didn't know that Gruber's plan to us was a lie. We didn't know. Well, now they know it's a screw job. They need to repeal it. Let's play this clip of Elijah Cummings savaging Gruber. Cummings is really good at acting like he doesn't know that he supports stuff that has basically double black unemployment in Maryland. Here's the clip. And then we'll...
Jonathan Gruber, for stupid, I mean absolutely stupid, comments he made over the past few years, and then drill and grill Administrator Taverner about what appears to be an inadvertent mistake in reporting ACA enrollment numbers. This may be good political theater, but it will not help a single American get health insurance. It will not help a single person get well. It will not help a single person get the care that they need.
This is how he talks to you like you're 5 years
old. Let me be clear. I'm extremely frustrated with Dr. Gruber's statements.
Your screw job's getting exposed.
They were irresponsible, incredibly disrespectful.
Well, for telling the truth about what you're involved in?
And did not reflect reality. And they were indeed insulting. I was in Congress when this law was debated. And Dr. Gruber does not speak for me. Or the chairman of the other committees who worked tirelessly.
Or the 12,000 pages of changes.
We debated this legislation for nearly a year.
You debated it, huh?
Before it was finally passed and signed by the president.
Did you read any of it?
He held 79 hearings and markups in the House of Representatives.
Of propaganda
alone.
And baloney.
Never once did I believe or did anyone suggest that we were somehow hiding our goals from the American people.
Yeah, you don't want our guns either.
But worst of all, Dr. Gruber's statements gave Republicans a public relations gift in their relentless political campaign to tear down the ACA and eliminate health care.
The Republicans helped write it.
Of America.
The Republican leadership.
Many Republicans now allege.
You mean good Republicans?
Some kind of Democratic conspiracy.
Oh.
Citing the praise for Dr. Gruber's work from President Obama and other Democrats. But that too is completely wrong. Let me highlight some additional praise Dr. Gruber received for his work. Dr. Gruber received the following thanks for his contributions to healthcare legislation, and I quote, Jonathan Gruber at MIT devoted hours and hours to an essential economic motto.
All right, let's not play any more of these lies. What do you make of this type of arrogance and hubris? Then we're going to skip this network break and go to phone calls.
You know, I think it's symptomatic of everything that's going on in Washington, D.C. It's constant. It's all about deceiving the stupid voters, as Gruber put it. If they couldn't deceive the stupid voters, they couldn't get away with this kind of arrogant crime spree.
Hence Common Core.
It is. It's all across the board. If you look at education, healthcare, all of it relies on deceiving voters who they think are stupid. And, that makes our job very clear. We need to educate the electorate and get these people out of office so that they'll stop destroying our country, stop trampling on our rights, and stop selling us out to organizations like the United Nations that are being used to take our guns and infringe on freedom around the world. It's that simple.
Well, they're just mafias that come in and hijack free economies, cut them up, divide them up, and then have a new scam to fix all the problems they've created before. And Cummings knows full well what he's done. Everybody knows what's in that bill up there in Congress. And see, now they're like, the Republicans want to get rid of what we've got. No, Boehner and McConnell don't. See, because when it all comes out that they're together on it, then they lose the Democrats. The only reason the Democrats are supporting is because they think the Republicans want to take their free goodie away, and they've had an imaginary victory. That's why you checkmate them when you actually bring out its bipartisan screw job. Jim in Missouri, thanks for holding. You're on the air worldwide.
Hey, thanks. Mr. Newman, I'd like to direct this question to you. I got a couple points I'd like to make. First of all, I believe that the local law enforcement is the biggest hurdle the government has in gun confiscation. But I'm wondering if the Obama administration will use these latest cases of police brutality.
They're trying to start a civil war. And so the UN can come in and demand that the citizens and local police are disarmed. That's in the UN original UNIDIR treaties and State Department Memorandum 7277 is to disarm the people, then the police, then the federal police, and only have UN peacekeepers, a monopoly of power by the world governments. Sorry, caller, go ahead.
Well, we keep seeing these police brutality cases, and the government, the Obama administration especially, jumps on these things, and whether they're true police brutality or whether they're not, they're criticizing the local law enforcement, and I just see this as a way for the Obama administration to turn the people against local law enforcement to help them further federalize the local law enforcement to be able to do whatever they want. I believe that local law enforcement is one main thing standing in the way of gun control, because we got a lot of sheriffs and police departments.
Absolutely.
That will not enforce it. But if the federal government has federalized local law enforcement, then they can do whatever they want. And
That's it. What you said is 100% true. Alex, any comments on that?
Yeah, we've been running for decades as a campaign supports your local police and keep them independent. And it's for exactly this reason. Local law enforcement is not the enemy. Obviously, there's, some bad apples, whatever you want to call them. And you find that all across society. It's not unique to police departments. The biggest problem is the federal control over local law enforcement, the militarization of law enforcement that's being carried out from Washington, D.C. So really, the source of these problems tracks back to the unconstitutional machinations by the federal government. And then you have people like Obama who have been showering military equipment on local police, stepping in and saying, oh, look, police militarization. So there's a very sinister agenda here. The UN is exploiting the same thing. They're trying to demonize local law enforcement here in the United States as, some kind of gung-ho, racist, lunatic wackos. And that's just not the case. The local law enforcement, that's our friends, that's our neighbors. They're part of our communities. And the globalists and Obama and all of these, they understand that this is one of the big hurdles to implementing their agenda.
Well, there's certainly some rotten areas in the country, but when the globalist weaponized media is attacking local police 24/7 and Hollywood's involved, you know it's bad. I mean, it's a no-brainer. When the enemy's doing something, I can intellectually track why it's bad, like Jim just said, like you just said, but it's just obvious. It's so outrageous. Anything else, Jim?
Yes, I would also like to make the point, I'm a pastor here in Missouri, and I would just like to say to all the pastors and Christians that are listening, we have an obligation to let people know what's going on. To any pastor or church member that believes that politics do not belong in church, I'm going to encourage you to read Ezekiel 33. We are the watchmen, and their blood is going to be on our hands. The blood of the people is going to be on our hands if we let all this happen and don't warn people about what's going on.
You're absolutely right. They want civil war in this country. That's how the communists take over. And again, it's powerful, rich people that want to sit offshore and bring the country down that are financing a classical communist takeover in America. It's incredible. And then they give all the federal training and these armored vehicles, knowing it makes local police look horrible. Then they come back in and go, we'll train them how to use these tanks right, while the people throwing the bottles work for the Justice Department on record. I mean, it's sick. Kevin in West Virginia, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hi. How are you both, Alexis? My question is, my family is nothing but hunters, and this whole disarmament treaty, I don't quite understand it.
Simple. Do you think a tiger or a lion wants a gazelle or a ding-ding it's going to eat? Some little deer? Do you think it wants it to have, like, big 10-inch fangs? No, it eats it because it'll roll over. So that's why they're trying to take your guns.
Well, I mean, we're hunters, and what scares me is that are we going to wake up Christmas morning with the Gestapo at the door saying, turn them in?
Yes, and it's being done in California and New York incrementally for little regulations and veterans where Bloomberg says, headline last year, gun confiscation has begun in California. I appreciate your call. Comments, how do you see them rolling this gun control by stealth?
I think the globalists and the Obama administration have figured out this straight, you know, frontal attack on gun rights is not going to fly. So it looks to me like what they're doing, first they want to get them registered, and this is how the UN treaty outlines that it should be done as well. You need a national control list of all the weapons, who owns all the weapons, what type of weapons, what type of ammunition, and just like all dictatorships throughout history, once they have the guns registered is when they'll come for the guns. So the first step will be registering. That's why you saw this huge push for the expansion of the background checks. They don't care about background checks. In fact, they love it when a nut job goes and shoots somebody.
Of course.
They want a list of everybody who owns weapons so that they can come and call.
And by the way, the Violence Policy Center, the Brady Center, the Austin Pro Team Mayor, Mike Martinez said in speeches, we're going to register and then we're going to confiscate their guns.
He laughed
at the gun owners and said, yeah, we are coming for your guns. Just like Gruber, they love to let us know.
Yeah, so if people don't fight back, there's serious trouble ahead for gun rights. But I think the globalists have realized now that, you know, Americans aren't going to sit back and take an attack on gun rights lightly. So they're trying to sell it as, you know, oh, just background checks. Who could be opposed to more background checks? And they want to chip away at it little by little until they can exploit a crisis to come out and grab them all after they're registered.
That's right. Great points. Chad in Washington, you're on the air with Alex Newman of the New American Magazine.
Oh, well, yeah, the last caller basically asked what I was going to ask. I just was hoping he could explain a little bit more. I don't remember who said it, but somebody was saying if a state doesn't really comply or the populace doesn't comply, then they'll send in the UN troops pretty much to disarm people. I was hoping he could just explain a little bit more.
Well, that's after the Civil War. See, first they destabilize the country, then they send the UN in to mop up later. Alex?
You know, people think it's ridiculous, the idea that UN troops might someday be in the United States. It's not ridiculous at all. And if you look at what the UN troops are doing around the world, now I've written on this extensively because in my opinion, it's one of the worst atrocities going on in the world and nobody's paying attention to it. These UN peacekeeping troops are systematically raping, slaughtering and pillaging the populations they're supposed to be protecting. It doesn't matter if you're looking in Haiti, the Ivory Coast, Sudan, Somalia, the Congo, any place where you find
Burma, Asia, literally being a news hound for 22 years, 20 years on air. No army in modern history has been more villainous, larcenous, murderous than the UN so-called peacekeepers. I mean, it is an army of evil.
It is. It's mind-boggling, and the media doesn't want to pay any attention to it. But the idea that they would be in the States is not as ridiculous as it sounds.
Look at the UN and sex trafficking of kids and women. They're the main driver of that. Do five more minutes with us if you can, Alex. And then we've got Gerald Celente coming up. We got a little no man's land. 5 minutes at some stations carry at the start. More calls, Alex Newman, then Gerald Celente with a first look at the trends of 2015.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNLive.com today.
The experts are clear. Sunlight, purified water, healthy non-GMO food, and having a good attitude is essential to a healthy immune system. But I go further with Super Nascent Iodine X2 from InfoWarsLife.com. 50% stronger than our original and revolutionary Nascent Iodine formula, coming from a deep earth crystal source that no other supplier has. Most other forms of iodine come from seaweed in areas plagued by Fukushima and other contaminants. Not our iodine. It comes from over 200 million year old crystal salt deposits and is tested and proven to be completely pure. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today. See the informational videos, read the information there compiled, and for a limited time, when you use promo code NOW at checkout, you get an additional 5% off the entire family of InfoWarsLife.com products. Secure your Survival Shield X2 today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll free 888-253-3139.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Alex Newman of the NewAmericanMagazine.com. I'm going to take a few final calls for you right now, but any other points you want to make about the UN treaty, a little Christmas gift that Obama says he'll implement by fiat?
Yeah, well, I mean, one thing that I think is important for people to understand, the UN is more of a tool of the globalists than a danger in and of itself. But with that said, withdrawing from the United Nations and defunding the United Nations would set the globalists back decades. They're thinking to use the United Nations as the nucleus of this global tyranny that they're trying to impose. And they're doing it on all fronts, human rights, global warming, all of these pseudo pretext for global government are being exploited. So if we could get the United States out of the UN, and there's a bill in Congress to do it right now, H.R. 75, Restore American Sovereignty Act, by Representative Brown in Georgia, if we could get the United States out of the United Nations, we would set the globalists back by maybe generations. And so I think it's a very worthy goal. It's a good goal for all of us to aspire to. We need to educate our communities about the danger of the UN, and we can use that momentum to defund and then withdraw from the Dictators Club.
And that's what it is. That's what really exposes the UN. They never criticize dictators and horrible regimes. It's always Christians, family groups, private property. And then it's a bunch of corrupt billionaires on top of it, like George Soros, telling someone that makes $100,000 a year how they're a greedy pig. Leon in Utah, thanks for holding. You're on the air with Alex Newman.
Hey, Alex. Hey, Mr. Newman and fellow patriotic citizen. The United States. I have a few things that I'd want to just point out real quick. I mean, what are we supposed to do, guys? What do we? What's the plan? I mean, overall, we can see that things are, you know, they're expanding in a way that's beyond our comprehension. In terms of they want to just, you know, knock on our doors and say, hand over your guns. You know, we know that people are going to stand their grounds, and we know that, you know, people are going to defend themselves, and it's going to be a bloodbath. To be honest with you, It's something that we all have to understand, and many people, I feel like they lack discipline because they don't listen. they're not aware of the things that are going on around us. I mean, just a couple of days ago, I guess, you know, Russia, or even today, they're threatening that, you know, that they're saying that America's sounding off the drum for World War III. I mean, you can obviously tell that things are, they're not right here. And, I mean, we know that violent protests take us nowhere. And, you know, they obviously don't agree with self-protection. And so what's the plan? What kind of action are we supposed to take? Aside from petitioning and protests, what's the answer here?
Me what they can do. I always say, first of all, resist calls for violence. Most of the time, those are probably going to be coming from federal provocateurs and globalists anyways. Resist calls to this divide and conquer. It's not about race. It's not about class. It's not about any of these things. It's about globalist criminals versus the people of the United States, their liberties, and all that is right and good in the world. Now, in terms of what to do, we have a lot of tools available to us. One of the most important is educating our communities. We still have our free speech. We still have the internet, so we can get the information out, and that is going to be key. We have the ballot box. We can vote bad politicians who don't obey their oath of office out of office. We have the jury, so, you know, don't convict your fellow citizens for trumped up crimes that the federal government or, you know, whatever imagines have been committed. So we still have all the tools that we need.
That's right. If the people become motivated and highly active and know what's happening, if all of you become media folks in your own area or activists or jury activists, whatever the case is, there's no way the globalists can be successful. If you just point people at New American Magazine or Infowars.com or WorldNetDaily.com or PrisonPlanet.com or DrudgeReport.com, not that any of us are perfect, but we're promoting basic information. Thomas Jefferson said that if you've got an informed public and you've got free information and you've got good information, that tyranny will vanish like phantoms at dawn. That's what's happening. And we're starting to see a lot of victories. Congress has a 7% approval rating. We just have to go to the next level to hold their feet to the fire. Alex Newman, we'll watch this treaty closely. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me, Alex.
You bet. We'll be back with Gerald Celente, the top trends forecaster.